Hello guys, Motion Tutor here, and in this After Effects tutorial I'm gonna be teach you how you can create sticky man animation using some reference footages. So you can use some stock footages as a reference footage to create the animation, or I will recommend you to record your own self footage to make animation. So like you can record any movement in real life and then you can bring that in After Effects and create a sticky man animation from that reference video. So if you are recording your own self footage, so you need to follow the two requirements. So number one is you can place your camera on a tripod to get a still camera shot, and the second requirement is you can record yourself on a side pose or in a front pose. So if you follow this, so you will get a better and good quality animation. So let's get started with the tutorial. So in this tutorial I will use this footage and show you how to make loop walk cycle using your footage. So if you understand this, so you can also create not loop but this type of dance or any movement sticky man animation. So the way is same, but making loopable animation with using your footage is little bit more tricky. So I will show you this and you can also understand the other way as well. So let's get started. So here I have footage, so you can see the footage is very long, but I trim this part only. So I will show you wait why. So this is footage. You can record your own footage or you can download whatever you want. So I will drag this footage, this is icon, and create a new composition. So now here you can see why I trimmed only this part. So you can see on first frame like leg is on ground and the second one is on same position, but it's a little bit above from ground. So in last frame the position of the person is changed, but the leg position are both similar. So like if I press in and out, so you can see. So that's why we will make a loop with it, but the position is changing. This is a little bit problem, so we will fix this as well. So you can press Ctrl R from keyboard and bring a ruler, and you can drag two lines here, put it something here on your footage. In between, in this line we have our foot on first frame, so we will press P and add a keyframe on position, and then we will go to last frame. And now we will change the X position of our layer to something like this. So now if I move this, so you can see it's not looking so much loopable because a background is moving as well. So that's why it's not looking loopable. Otherwise now our footage is loopable. So now we will trace this and create loopable walk cycle of sticky man animation. So you can go to layer and go to new and create a solid layer, and you can change the name or don't change the name, it's depending on you, and then click OK. And I will hide the guides and Ctrl R, and I will hide the rulers as well for now, and disable the layer for now, and go to first frame, and here you can select the pen tool and create a mask, rough, like not mask, create a path something like this. So you can see now we have something like leg shape of mask, and after this you can press M and add a keyframe here, and then you can go to around 3 frame forward. It's depending on your footage, how fast your footage is. For this type of footage you can go to around maximum 3 frames forward, and then you can add like adjust the mask, so like it will be take a little less time if you go to 3 frame forward, or if you do frame by frame, so it will be take more time. So now I will trace the whole video, entire video, like after gapping 3 frames. So like I added first keyframe here, and I will go to 1, 2, 3, I will adjust second time here. So like I will do this for entire video like this. So here you can see I almost traced the whole video, only 5 frames are left. So on this last 5 frame we will not trace this from our footage because we are making loop animation. So if we trace this, so it will not give us a perfect loop. So what we will do here, so we will select the first keyframe and press Ctrl C to copy the keyframe, and then we will go to last frame and press Ctrl V to paste the same keyframe on last frame. And now I will tweak the mask path little bit in between this gap. And then you can scrub through your timeline and see if between all the keyframes if any extra adjustment required, so you can adjust your path and add another keyframe between them. But in this footage I don't require any extra keyframe, After a gap of 3 frame, my entire path is looking perfect. And after that, you can search for stroke effect in effects and preset panel and then drag the stroke effect on this layer. And you can check all mask and then you can change the size to around 50 and change the brush hardness to 100 and change the paint style to on transparent. So now if I score, I can make it 10 because it's very thin. So you can see, and if I solo this layer, so you can see it's loopable and we don't see any cut or any glitch here, so it's looking very good. And after that we will track the second leg. So the process will be same. Select a pen tool and create a point something like this. So this is our first point, and after that I will add this point here and I will change this color to red as well, and then click OK and then press M and add a keyframe on path, and then we will follow the same step and trace the whole video. So I will fast forward this part. So here you can see again I am on the same point, 5 frames are left. So I will copy the first keyframe and paste it on the last frame, and then if we will tweak needed on the middle frame, so I will then now this little bit like tweaks are needed, so I adjust it there. And now if I enable the layer and I will show you, so you can see it's looking very good and very perfect loop here. So now I will fast forward the past and I will trace the body and I will trace the hands and I will then create a head and manually add a keyframe on that. So let's do it now. And for this body part, you don't need to add so much keyframe. So just you can add 4 or 5 maximum keyframe to give some movement to your character body. But if you are using some different footage where your body is moving so much like I did in the dance example, so then you need to add more keyframes. But in this example you can see I added some keyframes, not so much keyframes. So it's also depending on what type of movement you are tracing. But if you are tracing a walk cycle, so I suggest you to add less keyframe there. And after that I created another layer and here I will now tracing the hand movement. So here you can see the hand is moving more slow than the legs. So that's why I am adding keyframe after 6 frames. And by doing this it will save my little time and at the end the result will be same. And after that I will click on stroke color and change the color to little bit gray. And then I will change the stroke size to 7 as well. And here you can see the hand animation, it's not looking so much good to me. In the footage it's looking okay, but when I traced it, it's not looking so much good to me. So that's why now I will give it little bit more time and I will try to make it look more cool. And after that I will trace the second hand. And you can see the second hand is not showing properly in the footage. So don't worry about that, we will trace it very roughly. I will only add 4 to 5 keyframes on this. And then I will select the second hand layer and put it below to mid layer. So now you can see it's doing little issue with legs layer. So we want to put it below to legs layer as well. So now it's looking good to me. And now for creating the head, we will select a pen tool and we will go to the character face. Something like we will trace a face, not perfectly, but we will try to trace it. So something like this. So you can see we created a shape. And make sure disable the stroke, just white fill is enabled. And after that make sure you select the shape layer and then we will create a neck something like this. And make sure this color is white as well. So then select shape layer again and then you can select some dark gray color. And then you can create a trace there something like. So something like this. And now if I enable it, so you can see everything is gone black, but I don't know why. This first one I think is the face one, so I will select it and I will select shape one and change this color to white. And I will select the shape two and I will change this color as well white. And for the third one we will leave it black and I will disable the video for now. So now you can see we have something like this type of face shape. So then we will rename it all quickly, and after that I will enable my video. So after that I will place I will select the shape layer and I will drag it something here, and I will press Ctrl Alt and Home key to align the anchor point in center, and then I will select the pen behind tool and move this anchor point something here about where the neck is, and then I will press R and make the head little bit like this, and then I will go to content and I will select the neck path, and I will try to match this with our face, our whole body, so around here and something like this. So now it's looking okay to me. So let's animate him. For animation you can press P and press R to add a keyframe on both. So now we edit a keyframe on position and scale. So now you can select your mid layer and press M to see where you edit a keyframe on your mid layer. So like you can see, so I will add the head keyframe according to depth. So on 13, on this frame you can see the mid is going down, so I will make it down, and on this frame it's going little bit up, I will move it up, and this frame it's going up and it's rotating little bit I think, and on this frame it's going down and it will rotate it like this, and on this frame it's going up and it's rotating, and on last frame I will select the first keyframe, select and copy by pressing Ctrl C and Ctrl V to paste them. So now if I play, you can see in my video it's very, like you can see in this part the mid is going very down and also the head is going very down, so it's not looking very good. So we will make it little bit like this to make it not do this stuff here. So I change the mid position on this keyframe here, and now I will change this one as well because I don't like that. So if I play it now, so you can this, now it's loop looking very smooth and very good. So now this one is completely done and it's perfectly loopable, so we can use it on in your footage or in your picture. So you can see I cut the same footage a blank part. So here I will import this composition and then I will press Ctrl Alt and T from my keyboard, and this time ramp will be come, and now I will hold the Alt key and click on this stopwatch, and here I will type loop out. And then after that I will add this thing here, and after that I will like make this video full comp long, and I will make this intensity little bit low, and then I will press P and I will add a keyframe and I will move it here on start of timeline, and I will go to the end, or maybe I will go to around here and move it all the way out from our video, and then we will play and see and adjust the keyframe. You can see it's going very fast like crazy, but like this now it's also going very fast, so we will increase our timeline time. So maybe should now it's, so you can see now it's looking a way more good, and you can see now it's perfect, and that's how you can make a walk cycle loop. So I also like showed this one to you, and now I will tell you how to make a different animation using different footage, not a loop animation or walk cycle or etc. So here you can see I have a dance stroke footage, so the process will be same. You can create a new solid layer and then you can simply select the pen tool and start tracing the body parts. Like first of all you can trace legs and hands and etc, everything you can trace, and then you can add stroke effect, and then you can change some colors and make some adjustments, and that's it, the process will be all same. And that's how you can make Sticky Man animation using reference videos. So guys, that's it for this tutorial, and if you don't understand anything, feel free to ask a comment in comment section. I will reply to you and try to solve your issue. And if you enjoyed this tutorial and learned something new from this, so don't forget to hit the like button. And if you want to see this type of more tutorials, so hit the subscribe button, because I will make this type of tutorials on regularly basis. Thanks for watching, and I will be catching you in the next one. Bye bye.